Hello guys and welcome. Today I'm going to make a tutorial for you for making a trailer like you asked on the Facebook page. I told you I will make a video of it, so here it is. I'm going to start for you the video. Before we even start to make a trailer, there are a few essential things you really, really need. First of all, what you need is the program called ETS2 Studio. You see it over here already. Go to Google, type in ETS2 space Studio, and then click on the first link. It will open the page and click on download. Click on the Google Drive download. That is the most secure one and the easiest to use. So click on it and then click on the download icon over here. I already did it, of course. Well, you download it, save it to your computer, and I suggest you make a dedicated ETS2 map on your computer. I've got it over here as well. On my D drive I have a map called ETS2. If I open it, you will see all the things I use for ETS2. I used to have a lot more, but the hard drive I used that crashed a few weeks ago, so I lost everything, every single trailer, every single picture I made. So I hope I don't have to remake it, because I have to start all over again. So make a dedicated map of your computer. If you don't know how to do it, go to an empty field on the map, click on the right mouse button, go to new, and I click on map, and there it is. Give it a name, and for example, well, ETS2. Fair enough, right? So if you made a new map, I'm not going to make it, but this is how you do it. Right mouse button, click on new and then map, and give it a name for ETS2. Everything that has to do with ETS2, place it in here. I've got my ETS2 studio over here as well, and that is this program. So download it, save it on your computer, extract it, install it on your computer, and then you can run it. But you can't use it right away, because you also need a different program, because you have to draw and you have to paste logos in the program as well. It's not that you can use ETS2 and that this thing is doing the rest for you. No, you have to do it yourself. There are two programs that are really great to use. The first one is PaintNet. If you click on PaintNet, you'll see that you can download it, and that is not the one I wanted. I want to have the one in English. This one. Yeah, here it is. So www.getpaint.net. You go to download, click on it, and there you see there are two options. One for Windows 10, it's the paid version, and you've got the .pdn, that is the free version. Click on the logo and then click on the free download now, paint.net 4.0.21. Click on it, same as before, save it on your computer, extract it and install it. It's really, really easy. Everyone can do this. It's just a simple execute a file. Alright, if you have PaintNet, you can start basically. I'm not using PaintNet because I don't really like the program itself. I always work with Photoshop. I have got CS6 myself. If you want Photoshop as well, this is how it looks. If you want it as well, I have it over here. I can send it to you, and I can even install it on your computer, because this one has a little bit different installation techniques, because it's not legal. If you want me to install it, what you have to do is install TeamViewer on your computer, and I can take over your system and install it from the Netherlands on your computer. I think that is the easiest way for you guys to do it, because otherwise it will be a drag and it's not going to work. So when you have either PaintNet or Photoshop, you can start. What you need, and that's what I will send to you, is a template folder. This one is called the Complete Template Pack. It's 2.26 gigabyte. That is a huge one. Why is it so big? Well, because you have got all the trailers and all the trucks in it. You won't have the Scania S and R, the next gen trucks, because it's not integrated in ETS2 Studio. So you have to do it manually. It's a big job. It's not for now. What I want to do with you guys is make a MetDom 1988 trailer. I will go make a Profiliner. This, by the way, is ETS2. When you start, you will see this. That's a truck skin tool. You've got all the trucks, and you've got some custom builds as well. And you've got the trailer generator and the game variable editor. For now, we're going to use the trailer generator. You'll see the MD modding, MetDom 1988, the Romy TZ, SCS software, and the Fleming V. The Fleming V, that is the tandem trailers. You've got the SCS software, so the normal basic trailers you have in the game. This is the Romy TZ. I made this one with the mask logo on it, and this is the MetDom 1988. It looks pretty similar to the SCS software. It has a little bit more details in it. It looks nicer if you ask me. So we are going to use the MetDom 1988, and what you do now is important, because we picked this one. And we also need the template for the MetDom 1988 Profiliner. So open your template pack, and here it is, MetDom 1988. Don't use the SCS trailer on the MetDom or on the MD modding, because it will screw it up and it doesn't work. It doesn't work at all. You won't see it in game. It's completely screwed up. So you have to do it name by name, trailer by trailer. So, like I said, we're going to make a MetDom 1988. So open it, and these are the files you can use. It's a 2D flat picture, and you don't really see how it looks like in the end. I'm going to pick the Profiliner, just because I like it. And you drag and drop it from the folder right into your program. You can do it with PaintNet, but also with Photoshop, if you, like you see right now. Alright, so these are the sides. I'm going to select it. So these are the sides of the trailer. This one, this is the other side. This is the back end of the trailer. These two are the pallet trays. This is your rear fender, and I'm not really sure. This is your head, the front of the trailer. That's for sure. I think that this one is the top of the trailer, and if I'm correct, this one is the bottom of the pallet tray. Usually, always give those three the same color. Today I will do the same as I always do. So this is how it looks like, and we want to make it into a 3D model in ETS2 Studio. So the next thing is that is a step that we need a logo and we need a reference picture. So I found Mainframe. I always download a logo and a reference picture so I can go back to it, pick a color from it, and I will show it to you in game. All right. I already saved the pictures on my computer, but click on the right button and then save as. And I've got in my ETS2 map, I've got trucks and trailers. So here are my reference pictures. And like you see right here, it has a name existing out of letters and numbers. So no one will know that this is your Mainframe reference picture. So give it a name and call it Mainframe. Don't call another one with the same name. So give it a name that is easy for you to understand and easy to find. So I've got Mainframe, I called my reference picture Mainframe as well. Right. We also need a logo. So click on Mainframe and then type PNG. Why PNG, you might ask? Well, there is a reason for it. The PNG files, like you can see over here, has a logo and has a strange background. But if you use it in Photoshop, you will see only the logo and no background at all. We have a normal picture. So I will take this one. You'll see that is a normal JPEG picture and it has a white background. So you have to deselect, if you have to select it, erase it, and like you can see, this white is going to the complete logo. So if you erase the white background, you will also delete the complete logo. So that is why I always use PNG. PNG is a picture that already did the steps for you to delete the background, so you don't have to do it yourself. So PNG, and then always pick the biggest size, pick it as big as possible. But not this one. This one is blurry and it's not looking nice. No, this one is looking good. I already saved it on my computer as well, so we don't going to save it again. Now we are in our Photoshop folder and I've got a map in my ETS2 folder called logos. You'll see my logos are in this folder. I've got the two files. This is the Mainframe JPEG file with the white background. Then you have to delete it yourself and drag and drop it into your picture, and now you will see what I meant. There is no background, so you don't have to delete it. It's just the logo itself. So we're going to my trucks and trailers, and I'm going to drag and drop the Mainframe trailer in Photoshop as well. Let's see, where is it? Here it is. Right. It doesn't work right now because I have to acknowledge that this one is on the right place. It's not the right size yet. We'll resize it in a moment. Here is my Mainframe reference picture. And don't drag it into the same place as your template is, because if you do it, it will look like this. So you have a reference picture on top of your layer where you want to make your trailer. You don't want that to happen. So don't place. You have to drag it right next to this one. You'll see that there is a text next to it. It's called copy. In Dutch it's a different name, but this is copy. And now it will paste it next to your template. The reason why I do this is because I can pick a color from the trailer. It has the main freight blue is the same as the trailer. If you have different colors, you can click on the paint bucket, as this one, and then click on your color picker. There it is. Now you'll see a complete range of colors. And there is a some sort of a syringe. And you can hover over the trailer, click on it, and it will select the color you pick. If I click on the white one, you'll see that it turns to white. Now it goes to the blue. I can also pick on the yellow. There it is, yellow. That is the yellow from the sticker. Maybe the green from the grass. But for now, we want the main freight blue for the rest of the trailer. Click on OK. And then go back to our picture. You'll see over here, it is still the same blue. Alright. We want to have the sides and the back in blue. On the reference picture, you see that a pallet tray is also in blue. Sometimes it has a different color. The bumper itself usually is white or black. So for now, the whole trailer is blue. So I click on my my rectangular marquee tool, and I'm going from corner to corner. Click on the mouse, left mouse button, hold it, and drag it to the right lower corner, and then release your left mouse button. You'll see it is selected right now. You see this dotted line on the side. This is I do this because I can fill the layer and fill it completely. I can also select smaller part and then fill only the selected part. As you can see, we've got layer 0 and we've got the main freight logo, that's this one. We need a new layer, so click on the new layer tool. There it is, layer 1, and we click on our paint bucket. Go into the field and click on your left mouse button. Kablam, it's blue. Now don't panic, because you don't see your background anymore. There is an eye, that's the layer of visibility. You can click on it. Now it's disabled, enabled, disabled, enabled. Like Dora, disabled, enabled. So click on the eye and you will see your layers below. If I work with several different colors, I will do the next thing. So I zoom in a little bit. Same as before, I hold my left mouse button and I'm only going to select the bumper. Select it. It doesn't matter if you're a little bit bigger than the picture itself. That doesn't really matter. Don't make it too big. A little bit is no problem. I want to make the rear bumper, I want to make it black. So I'm going to my color picker. I will with my mouse arrow on black. This is black, it's pitch black. So we've got layer 1, we need a new layer. Obviously, layer 2. Click on the paint bucket again, and because we selected only this one, I can click on it in my layer 2, and then it's black. Only the selected part. All right. Now I want to deselect it, and I have to press on the control button on the keyboard and press on the letter D. So control D. Like this. CTRL D. And I think it's best if you make some notes. So control D for deselect. Right. I'm going to delete the text. It made a new layer. I'm going to delete it because I don't need it. So click on the right mouse button, click on delete layer. Now it's gone. Right. Going back to the main freight logo. As we saw on the picture, it's nicely in the middle of the trailer. So go back to it. The main freight logo, here it is. You're gonna click on it, edit, transform, and scale. You'll see that is back to the beginning. Usually I always paste it in, I resize it properly, and then make my next step. It was nicely in the middle. It was pretty big, maybe like this. So I think this is a nice spot for the logo. Click on the arrow button and it will tell you place the file. Yes, place. All right, we also want it on the other side of the trailer. So you can click on copy layer and paste it, but you can also use the Alt button on your keyboard. So press on Alt, and like you see right now, you have a black arrow with a small arrows next to it. If you click on Alt, you'll see that the arrow indicator is changing to a black and white arrow. That means that you selected this logo. You can do it with every logo you want, every picture, every color, doesn't matter. Click on the logo you want to copy and click on the Alt button, and now you'll see that it is black and white. And you can hold Shift as well. If you hold Shift, you can lock the image. If you lock the image, it means that you can go from the left to the right, but not up and down. So it is exactly aligned from left to right. If you want to go up and down, you hold your left mouse button. That's what I want to do now. And drag it down. Hold Shift, drag it down, like this. I can try to move it to the left, but it doesn't work because it is locked. So it is on the exact same spot as the official logo. So now release your mouse button, release your Alt and Shift button, and it is placed over here. So align it a little bit that it is on the same height as well. I like this one. And you'll see that it is fully black, fully blue. So I'm going to place this layer down. So I hold my mouse button, and then you can select the layer and you can move it up and down. So now you see that this logo is on top of the blue. Later on you will see how it looks in 3D. Deselect it again, because we also had a white inlay. So we make a new layer, pick a rectangular marquee tool, and then select from left to the right, a little bit like this. Yeah, I think this is nice looking. So hold your mouse button, select it, release the mouse button on layer number 3, click on your fill bucket, then on your color picker again, we want the same white as the logo. So with your syringe, or what is it? In Dutch it's called a pipette. I don't know if it is in English it's the same, but for now I will call it the syringe. And maybe color picker, even better. I will call it color picker. So you click on the white and then click on OK, because you see it is changed to white. Click on OK. We made a new layer already, and we click on the left mouse button inside the selection. Click, there it is. click on the arrow and press Control D. So deselect, so the selection is gone. Layer 3 is the white layer, so we also want to have it on the top. So again, Alt and Shift and drag it up. Place it on the same place as the other one, like that.
Okay, there we go. I'm still washing around trying to sort things out.
Pick the blue. Now you see it's starting to form already, like this one. I'm not going to paste in this grayish line on top. I'm not going to place in the corner. I will only use, and this is a Krone, I will only use the Krone logo. I already downloaded, of course, from the internet, and I will go to my logos folder, and there it is, Krone. So download a bunch of logos, download a bunch of brands, save it on your computer. And this is also a PNG file, so easy for me. There it is, but it's a huge one. You might ask, why is it so huge? Well, it's huge because it's detailed. I'm going to do deselect the blue because I want to have it in the middle of the palette tray. So there it is, the Krone logo. Click on Edit, Transform, and Scale. And when you're starting to do it yourself, I suggest that you click on the pause video, so you can execute it yourself. You see that there is a resize arrow from upper left to lower right, and the selection around this logo. Now we can hold the left mouse button and resize it to the size that we feel comfortable. Now it is really small, so zoom in, pick up the logo, and place it in the middle, like that. Click on the arrow in the top left, that's the move tool, and click on place. Alright, same again, we're going to make a copy and we're going to place it on the other side of the trailer as well. So Alt, and now we don't need Shift because you see that this one is a little bit more to the left, so we want to free move the logo. So click on Alt, it's made and made a copy of it, and now you can move around. If I click on my Shift button, then it's locked. I can only go up and down now. If I release my Shift, I can freely move it again. So I'm feeling comfortable as it is. Right over here, with my arrow buttons, I can fine tune it like that. That's what I like. It's in gray, so if it is the blue one, now you see the gray logo. Nah, that's not what I want. I want to have it white. Here is my logo, and it's selected. I click on my right mouse button on top of the layer. I'm going to blending options. Click on it. Now you see your blending options. You can place a shadow, you can give it a glow, give it a pattern, you can play around with it. I'm not going to show it to you right now. The only thing I will show you right now is the color overlay. If you click on the checkbox, you'll see that it is bright red right now. We don't want to have a bright red, we want to have a white. So click on the word instead of the checkbox. Click on the word. And now there is a new menu, the color overlay. Here it is, the bright red that we don't want to use. Click on it, go to the white or any other color you want. For now, pick white, click on it, and click on OK. Now press OK again, and see what happens. It is white instead of gray. I'm going to do the same with the top one. Right mouse button, blending options, color overlay, if you click on the word right away, you will see that the checkbox is filled in as well. Click bright red. We don't want to have a bright red. We want to have it white like the other one. There it is. I'm going to change it to 6xF. There it is. F is white. You don't have to remind that. If you pick white, that's fine. Click on OK. Now we've got two white Krona logos on top of the blue. All right. We have the blue. We've got the white bars. We've got the logos in it. We've got a black bumper and we've got the two Krona logos. But there is also a back of the trailer. It's this one. I think I want to have the main freight logo over here as well. So click on Alt and move it. And it's too big. Click on Edit and click on go to Transform and click on Scale. Now you can resize it so it fits nicely on the back of the trailer. A little bit less height. Click on it. There it is. A little bit to the left so it's nice in between those lines. These are the bend lines. So the on the trailer door you see that it is bended a little bit. Right, usually companies have some information on the back of the trailer as well. So let's see if we can find some information. And this is how I always make my trailers. I always search the internet for information and for good reference pictures. I don't see it, so what I do, main freight contact. Not on pictures, but on all. And main freight UK contact. Global contact main freight, there it is. That is not what I read. Global contact. Is it this one? No, it's the same. All right. We can contact them with a form. We don't want that. Well, here it is, main freight. It's on 4 Nexus Close, Central Way, Feltham. You can select it like this. Press Control C for copy. Now you copy the text from the internet, go back to your Photoshop folder. Now you click on the letter T, that is the text tab. Click somewhere in your screen and press Control V. You see that the text is in it in white. So if I bring back the blue, you'll see that it is nicely white on top of the blue. It's not how I want it to look like, so I want to have it a little bit different. So click inside the text and press on backspace and then press on enter. One back. So we've got 4 Nexus Close, Central Way, Feltham. Is it correct? 4 Nexus Close, Central Way, Feltham. It's in the UK. Let's bring in the phone number as well. Good morning, Jay. Control and C. Back to Photoshop. Look forward to the weekend. Keep it up, buddy. And we're going to place the text on the left side of the door. It is too big. So, because we want to replace.
Minute they decided they were going to let the kids in, and I had to rush off. So yeah, there we go. But we're going to jump into the next request now. The next request is from
AEK177. Really sorry, buddy. You've been here for a while, and you keep putting requests in and shouts in, and I just can't read your name. My apologies. You're going to have to try and put it in brackets or something and tell me how to say it, because I've got no idea. I might even try Googling it or something silly like that and see if I can work it out. But there you go. I don't have the exact song you're after, unfortunately. As I said, I am going to be updating my library at the weekend, so hopefully I'll be able to get some better tracks for you guys out there. I will play something else from the artist. I just don't have the song you require. So we're going to play this one. Hopefully you enjoy, and if not, chuck me another request in and we'll see what we can do.
We were staying in Paris to get away from your parents, and I thought, wow, if I could take this in a shot right now, I don't think that we could work this out on the terrace. I don't know if it's fair, but I thought, how could I let you fall by yourself? Well, I'm wasted with someone else. If we go down, then we go down together. They'll say you could do anything. They'll say that I was clever. If we go down, then we go down together. We'll get away with everything. Let's show them we are better. Let's show them we are better. Let's show them we are better. We're staying in Paris to get away from your parents. You look so proud, standing there with a fountain, a cigarette, posting pictures of yourself on the internet, out on the terrace. We breathe in the air of this small town, on our own, cutting glass with the thrill of it, getting drunk on the past we were living in. If we go down, then we go down together. They'll say you could do anything, they'll say that I was clever. If we go down, then we go down together. We'll get away with everything. Let's show them we are better.
Let's show them.
If we go down, then we go down together. We'll get away with everything. Let's show them we are better.
We were staying in Paris.
If we go down,
we were staying in Paris.
If we go down,
we were staying in Paris.
We go. Hopefully you enjoyed that one, guys, and we're gonna jump into the next one. We are indeed. Let me just see if I can find it. Where did it go? Okay, this is for Sam, I think. Is this Sam? No. Who's this? Who are we playing this for? Oh, okay, it is Sam. Right, sorry. I don't have the song that he asked for, that's why. But I've got the same artist, so I'm playing a different song. So, yes, Sam, my apologies. And try and remember, guys, to, if you're going to request a song, put it in the requests, because I don't always see them otherwise. Unfortunately, Sam put his in the compilation section, and I almost missed it, to be honest. I almost missed it. So, yeah, it's a good idea to try and put them in the right department. So, if it's going to be a request, make sure it says request. If you're going to do a shout-out, make sure it's a shout-out. If it's something unrelated, then stick it in other. We will be doing a traffic update as well in a little while, so if there's any traffic news you want me to read out, head on over to truckers.fm, hit that request button, and let me know in the traffic section what's going on out there in the world of trucks. So we're going to jump over to Sam's song. As I said, I don't have the exact song, but we're going to play this one instead. So this is No Money. Hopefully you enjoy.
Sorry, I ain't got no money. I'm not trying to be funny, but I left it all at home today. You can call me what you wanna. I ain't giving you a dollar. This time I ain't gonna run away. You might knock me down. You might knock me down. But I will get back up again. You can call it how you wanna. I ain't giving you a dollar. This time I ain't gonna run away.
There we go, Sam. Hopefully you enjoyed that one, and once again apologies for not having the exact song. I do try my best, and this is what I always say to you guys: if you do send in a request, then please make sure you give me the artist as well as the song title, because if I don't have the song, then at least I can try and find the artist. And I'm gonna be honest, my song knowledge isn't that great, so if he was to say, you know, blah 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 song, I may not know who that artist is, so therefore then can't search for it, and then you don't hear anything because I don't have it. So always try and put in the artist as well as the song title, and then at least that way I can try and play something for you. And honestly, if you really don't like the choice that I've picked, if I don't have your song, then you're more than welcome to chuck another request in and we'll play something different, you know.
Not ADR, it's not fragile, it's not liquid, it's not refrigerated or construction machinery. Well, when the baby is done, it's a construction, but not in the form we are driving it. This is the locations where you can, where the trailer is spawning, and this is where you can drive to bring it. I don't really care if it is accurate or not. I just want to see the trailer on all places because I made such effort on it. I want to see it in game on every single place you can imagine, even on a quarry, because we don't care. So click on the right mouse button and select all. Do it in this area as well. Right mouse button and select all. You see that there is a green check mark and ready. and click on Save Cargo. Now you see that your diapers are in the cargo list as well. So you click on diapers and you see that the cargo details changed from assorted, what I already have, is changing to diapers. But it is not selected yet. So we've got the cargo details of the diapers and I click on the checkbox diapers. Now we've got a green check mark as well. All green means go. Click on export mod. And it's exporting the mod as your main freight trailer. So give it a name, main freight. And it's, don't use one of those because that is the picture. Just select main freight because it is an SCS file. Click on save. And now it is the main freight. There it is. It's an SCS file. It's a WinRAR file on my computer. On your computer it might be different, but it's an SCS file. Alright. We want to copy this one and go to our documents, then ETS2 mod folder and paste it in. Same as you always do with your own mods. Going to start up Steam. If you wonder who this is on my background, that's my wife. I'm sure she doesn't appreciate it if I tell you that this is my wife. So going to my map platforms, Steam, and we're going to start our game. Come on Steam, you can do it. Almost, and there it is. New releases. Let's go to the game. Click on play, launch. Now the game is starting. The moment it's beginning, I click on escape, so we can skip. I guess escape, and jump right back to our profile. Right, this looks familiar to you guys, I hope. Going to pick my cheat tutorial because that's an almost empty one. It's loading quick. There is a new mod. And there it is, main freight, the one we just made. Later on, you can give it a picture as well, an icon, but that is for now, it's not really that important. Click on save changes. And continue game. Let's see how it looks. First time it's loading the game, it's always taking its time. From now on, it's going faster every time. In the game, when you made your mod, it's going faster, at least on my computer. On my pro mods file, profile, it's going slow as well. It takes up to a minute, maybe sometimes two. Right. I'm not sure what it is in your game, but we are going to the icon next to exit. It's called about, I think. We're going to trailer browser. And then it was main freight, and there it is, main freight. And there it is, our main freight trailer. Nice, guys. The back. And there it is, the black bumper. Well, that's looking good. Press on F10, make a screenshot. Maybe a little bit more to the side. Press F10 again, not a screenshot. Alt and top, because I'm curious if it looks similar to the original picture.
Every Saturday from 6 to 8 p.m.
I've got some sort of a virus because I downloaded the game and now I've got a Russian spam, so I have to fix it. Alright, so this is our main freight trailer we just made, and there is the original one. I think it looks pretty good, pretty accurate. We're not having those corners and we are not having those lines. When I make a detailed drawing, I will edit it and I will paste it in all. I will do the label area and everything like it's on this trailer. But for now, I'm really happy with it. So you've got it in your game. You can drive it around and you will see it on the road as well. So that is how you make a trailer. It takes some time, but when you are getting familiar with it, it's getting faster and faster. So use this video as a reference, and the moment I tell you guys to copy the picture and paste it in Photoshop, pause the video and follow my step. I've got a dual monitor. Most of you guys have dual monitors as well, so I've got my video, my instruction videos on my left monitor, and I've got my programs right in front of me, so I can see on the left what I'm doing and execute it on the right, on the second monitor. That's how I usually work. Of course you guys have to do what you like best, but this works for me really well. If you don't have two screens, you have to jump from video to program, video program, and so on. But for now, this is the basics of a trailer, and well, you've got, as you can see, you've got all kinds of trailers. You've got this is the container, and you've got the nice one with the lights on it. And this one, I don't understand this one completely, so I've never made this one. But these are the trailers you can make. So click on the trailer generator. If you want to make a truck, well, that's a different story, different template, same way basically, but some other steps if it comes to the drawing. So I hope it is a little bit clear for you guys, and I hope you understand a little bit better what you have to do to create a trailer. If you have any questions, just ask them, and don't be afraid to ask a question. There are no stupid questions, because it's new for you guys. You have to learn it. I had to learn it as well. I asked John, I asked him a gazillion questions. He was a brilliant help, and he pulled me through, and from his help I went to YouTube and I searched some instruction videos to make the trailers, make the trucks. And after a few times, I didn't need it anymore and I could do it on my own. And within a few weeks, I was making some nice stuff. So I hope you guys can do it as well. I'm going to close up the programs because I'm done editing. I'm going to do another game, and I will see you guys again on Facebook on the road. And for now, I wish you a really nice weekend and talk to you soon. All right, bye bye guys, have a nice day.